I'd just like to spend a short amount of time explaining what a high blood sugar means. I think a lot of people will look at their blood sugar and they'll say, well, it's not that high, or it's up for a short amount of time, or maybe more commonly, I feel fine, so what's the problem? But a blood sugar is important, and I think it's worth understanding, because sugar in the form of glucose is actually quite vital to normal bodily functions. 40% of all the glucose that we have and consume that goes into our blood is actually used by the brain. And it's used by the brain to power all the activity that runs our body. Now, critically, the brain is able to access sugar in the blood and absorb it whether or not you have insulin. But let's just take a step back and let's think about what happens normally. Well, glucose in the form of a sugar or a carbohydrate travels around the body in your blood. And when it gets to a cell, particularly muscle and fat cells, it requires the action of insulin, which acts as a key which binds to the lock on the cell surface, unlocking a door called the glucose channel. And that lets sugar leave from the blood and enter the cell. And it pretty well sits in perfect balance. Without diabetes, a person's blood sugar rarely fluctuates at all. But if you have diabetes, the values can go up and down quite substantially. Now, what functionally that means is that if your blood sugar is high, then the sugar hasn't entered into the cells to where it should be. Now, in a perfect situation, a person will have a normal blood sugar, and that typically is between 4 and 5 millimoles all the time. But let's just imagine for a second that your blood sugar is 16, and it should be 4. So it's effectively 4 times higher than it should be. Now, if the blood sugar is high, it means that the glucose hasn't been transferred and absorbed into the cell. So at a cellular level, within the cell, there's 4 times less sugar than there should be. The cells are, in effect, in a state of starvation. And because they're in a state of starvation, they let your body know about it. And they produce chemicals and signals that tell your body that it needs to eat and that you need to find sugary foods and sweet foods that contain carbohydrate. And because the cells are starving, they're all working so very inefficiently, which results in you as a person with diabetes being very tired and fatigued. And I think over the years, if there's one thing that people have said to me once they get their sugars down, is just how much more energy they have and how they didn't realize how tired they were. The other problem is that sugar is a fairly nasty chemical, and it's nasty to the lining of blood vessels, and that's the reason that the body keeps it at this very consistent low value. High blood sugars damage the lining of blood vessel walls. And that creates an increased likelihood of developing problems from diabetes around blockages to blood vessels and the deposition of cholesterol in the walls of the blood vessels, which leads to heart attacks and strokes. So whether you have type 1 diabetes, type 2 diabetes, or you have diabetes in pregnancy, a high blood sugar is going to do a number of things in the short term, as well as cause a number of problems in the long term. It is well worth knowing that, because the more normal your sugars, then the better you'll feel, the more energy you'll have, the less hungry you will be, and the less likely over time you are to develop complications.